Op maandag 8 november 2021 hebben de ambassadeurs van Turkije, Namibië, Colombia en de Dominicaanse Republiek hun geloofsbrieven aan president Chandrika Prasad Santokhi aangeboden. In navolging van dit viertal hebben op dinsdag 9 november 2021 ook de diplomaten van Oostenrijk, Vietnam, Angola en Servië hun opwachting gemaakt bij het staatshoofd. Deze afgevaardigden en minister Albert Rangdien van Buitenlandse Zaken, International Business en Internationale Samenwerking geven als volgt hun verwachtingen weer.
Vandaag heeft de voorzitting plaatsgevonden van het aanbieden van geloofsbrieven door een aantal andere landen, waaronder Angola en ook Oostenrijk, Vietnam en Servië. En zoals ik al gisteren zei, we hebben met sommige van de landen hebben we al hele intensieve betrekkingen. Met andere is het beginnend. Maar wat wel interessant is, en dit wilde ik wel meegeven aan de samenleving. Dit is een gebruikelijk proces. Dat van tijd tot tijd nieuwe ambassadeurs hun geloofsbrieven aanbieden. En daarmee officieel de relatie bevestigen tussen de landen.
It was a great honor and privilege today to be so warmly received by the federal president and talking about the future, planning for post-COVID and to seek out the many areas where our two countries can cooperate. We identified particularly two areas. This is education in mining, where we have one of the oldest universities in the world in Austria, where we would like to make available places and scholarships for students from your beautiful country. And secondly, forest management, where Austria also has a very, very strong capacity, the oldest forest schools actually in the world, and we see here many, many complementary interests between our two countries.
Evening, Ambassador. You just handed over the credentials to the President of Suriname. What are your expectations for both countries?
I had the honor today to hand over my letters of credence as the first ever Ambassador Extraordinary and Plenipotentiary of the Republic of Serbia to Suriname. In the meeting with His Excellency President Santokhi, I saw the will and the energy to build up this country in the same way I can feel in my own country. And this enthusiasm and the love of the people of this country that I can feel for the country is something that I think we have in common. But not only that, I want to share with you and with our friends and brothers from Suriname that Serbia, as the fastest growing European economy for a second year in a row, is very interested in expanding its economic and political cooperation with Suriname, its cooperation in the educational sphere, where we already have 26 students from Suriname studying at our universities. This number will even increase in the years to come. Already next year, I expect a significant increase in the number of students from Suriname studying in our country.